born. The nurses all gathered round, and they gazed in wide wonder at the joy they had found. The head nurse spoke up, said, "Leave this one alone." She could tell right away that I was bad to the bone. Bad to the bone. Bad to the bone. Bad. 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 Bad to the bone. I broke 1,000 hearts before I met you. I'll break 1,000 more, baby, before I am through. I wanna be yours, pretty baby. Yours and yours alone. I'm here to tell you, honey, that I'm bad to the bone. Bad to the bone. Bad. 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 Bad to the bone.
But the last straw, I mean, normally on a weekend, I like to go to the beach, sip a nice whiskey, Abelour 16 years old, if anyone wants to give me a Christmas present, and enjoy myself. But I heard on TV, Mark McGowan. I was just preparing for my TV show. I look up, and there he is saying, "Milo Yiannopoulos is not welcome in Western Australia, and no buildings of the government will be allowed, given him permission to go into." And I thought, what is this? What kind of country is this? You don't have to agree with Milo. In fact, last night in Adelaide, I said to Milo on stage, "I don't agree with this and this that you just said. You're too rude for me." Well, that's all I said. I mean, we're all entitled to disagree and have discussions. He explained why, and I thought, ooh, and the audience was for him. I lost, so what? The point is, we have debate in this country, or we did. We did. And I resolved, that's it. I am going to Western Australia, and I am going to MC Milo Yiannopoulos and Mark McGowan, stick that up your kilt. I'm even starting to talk like Milo. I'm actually a quite polite person. Now, we don't have going to speak in Sydney. Protesters, blah, blah, police. Ooh, the police actually said to the organisers, "Fine, you can speak. We'll provide 260 police for security." And they said, "And we'll charge you $80,000. And you think, how does this work? So the more that the left create mayhem, like you saw, it was at the same venue where Tony Abbott's sister was attacked and had her jacket ripped off. You remember that? The more mayhem they cause, the more police are forced to defend them, the more the target of their anger must pay a bill. Who's got $80,000 just for the policing and the fences and all that? That's ridiculous. And then the venue cancelled anyway. They demanded a $30,000 security for the damage that the protesters might do, and Milo's tour promoters had to pay for it. How does that work? Same thing in Melbourne. We'll provide all these police, come speak, we'll defend free speech, it's going to cost you $48,000. What's this country come to where the targets of violence must pay the police to uphold the law and protect them? No wonder so many people here stay stumm, and that you have to wait for someone from America to come here to talk about free speech in a country where you would have thought free speech is our birthright. It's defended, right? Unfortunately, no. So I want to congratulate you for coming in here, defying everything, and you're going to get Milo in a minute. But of course, the guy paying the bills like many other people won't and can't afford, to actually have him come over here, say, yes, we'll pay that, just to defy them, just to have them do it, is the publisher of Penthouse, Damien Kosas. Give him a hand.
Thank you, Andrew. You know, we get a lot of mail at Penthouse, and
Dear Penthouse!
That's true, we do. To be perfectly honest, until about 2 months ago, we really looked forward to opening it. Most of the time it was either praise for one of our models or a new shoot or, you know, something like that. One of those, you know, Dear Penthouse letters, you know, those ones that many of us remember reading fondly as teenagers. Anyway, but about 2 months ago, around the same time we announced we were going to bring out Milo, the mail changed from Dear Penthouse, you'll never believe what happened to me in the office supply room last night, to, and this is actually a very real example, Dear Penthouse, why are you supporting Milo Yiannopoulos? Thought you were down with Fanny, not fascism. This is really disappointing. And one of my staff actually brought this to my attention, and I just said, look, ignore it, they're entitled to their opinion. But it became increasingly obvious, however, as time went on, that these people didn't feel that we were entitled to the same. And one night I was working late, as we tend to do, and that's another story, but I decided to log on and have a look at some of the messages on our various social media platforms, and I came across this message from a chap who calls himself Trent. And it was quite amusing, and I'll read it in a second, but I clicked on his Facebook profile, just out of interest, to have a look at the guy. And as it turns out, it was a joint profile with his wife, which really should have been the first giveaway. Very good. Anyway, Trent and Susan, a wholesome white couple, no doubt overwhelmed with the guilt of their white privilege. They're pictures together standing at Uluru, whatever the hell they call it these days, with one of those rainbow flags across their you know, those filters across their profile pic, and I shit you not, and you can't make this stuff up, they're holding up a sign that says proud owners of a gay dog. But the message read as follows: since you're sponsoring hate mongers and are willingly complicit in divisive ethno-nationalism, I'm going to remember you when the niceties of civilization are out the window and we all get divided up into war criminals and death camps. How dare you sponsor and support this divisive fuckwit going around spewing hate in a country already full to burst with racists and homophobes. The last thing Australia needs is an attention-seeking Trump sock puppet spewing filth across the country and further marginalising minorities. Who do you people think you are? Get with the times, you crusty old dinosaurs. Now, I was going to leave it. Yeah, but the next day we got another one, and, you know, after about 50 or 60, I thought, I'm going to respond. I have to. So one night I was working late and I had a few drinks. As you do. And I thought, you know what, I'm gonna do it. So rather than go into chapter and verse, you know, and sing some sort of sanctimonious soliloquy about how great Penthouse is and how great I am, I'm just going to read you my response to Trent. And I hope that everyone here understands, you know, from this response, what Penthouse is and why we do what we do. So here goes. Dear Trent, thank you for your email. You've made some interesting points and asked some poignant questions that I will attempt to clarify for you as best as I can. But first, I would like to pose a question to you. What do you think Penthouse Magazine and Milo Yiannopoulos have in common? It's very simple. You. Both have fallen foul of people like you, the new culture correctors. Both have been found wanting by finger-wagging culture policers who insist, like little Stalinists, that culture must have the right moral message or face the chop. People like you who seem to think that because the left won the culture war over the last 20 years, that you have some sort of cultural gerrymander that the rest of us must accept every time you say, I'm offended. In our office, we call people like you pretend progressives. I wouldn't even give you the privilege of calling you left. You, my dear chap, you, your wife, and your queer dog are nothing more than leftovers. You're so caught up in the virtue signalling and the fight for your ideology that you forget the fight of your predecessors. You fail to realise that the fight was never about right and left, but about right and wrong. The left was once a great movement that boasted contributors like Martin Luther King, that understood that it's not about the colour of a person's skin, but the content of their character. This great movement has been reduced to the likes of you. And I fear something has gone terribly wrong in the 21st century. People like you seem to fancy this new millennium is free and open and wild, so much so that you can choose your own gender, cover yourself in tats and remain an overgrown teenager into your 30s and no one will bat an eyelid. Yet alongside this seeming libertarianism, there's a dark hostility toward the most important freedom of all, the freedom upon which all other freedoms are built, the freedom of speech. Penthouse magazine has been fighting for this freedom since it began in 1965. And while people like you sit in your safe space and bark like the village idiot, Bob Guccione and the freedom fighters of old were literally being shot at in order to build the soapbox from which you and your kind are now shouting at us. And I'm sure you see the irony here. You're screeching at the very people that defended your right to speak for the last 50 years, and you're using that right to suppress ours. But you know what? I don't think you get it. Because you said it yourself, get with the times, you crusty old dinosaurs. I can only assume that you feel like people like Milo and publications like Penthouse haven't had the benefit of evolution to the same degree as you and your heroes, which I can only presume include the likes of Clementine Ford and Waleed Ali. And on this point, I have to agree. When you bear witness to the miracle that is human evolution, you can only revel in how much we've evolved as a species. When we have walking proof, like Waleed and Clementine, that humans have evolved to the point that we can now conceive from anal intercourse. I trust you're smart enough to sense my sarcasm. I don't have the time or the inclination to educate you, so I'll leave you with this. When you spend so long looking down your nose and attempting to silence those with whom you disagree, don't be surprised when people turn around and say, you know what, Trent? Fuck you. Yeah. Have a great night and enjoy the show.